Hey, hey, girls and guys, and welcome to a beautiful math problem that will for sure be a big surprise for you if you've never seen something like this before. My name is Magda, I'm a mathematician from Germany, and I would love to help you improve your English language skills at the same time as you're training your mathematical abilities. It might be useful at the beginning to activate the subtitles, because now we are going to examine the sponge miracle. The miraculous thing about this task is that the solution of the question is totally unexpected, and you will guess something probably very different from the real solution. We have a sponge, and we know that this sponge is soaked with water. In total, this wet sponge weighs 1 kilo, and we know that 99% of its weight is water. Now we are squeezing the sponge so much that only 98% of its weight is water, and we want to know what the weight of the sponge is now after squeezing it. Maybe try to guess. Write something down, what comes to your mind without calculating, and then stop the video, start calculating, and you will see that most probably you were quite wrong. I calculated in this way. I said the whole sponge with the water is 1 kilo at the beginning, and we will say it's the whole weight, so 100%, and we can divide it into the water, which was at the beginning 99%, and the sponge's weight, which is 1%. Now it's just some easy calculations from maybe grade 8. We have to calculate 0.99 times 1 kilo or times 1000 grams, and then this will end up with 990 grams, which means that from 1 kilo, 990 grams is water, so 10 grams are there remaining for the sponge itself. Now we want to find out the weight of the wet sponge after it has been squeezed. That means it will not be 1 kilo anymore, and the division will be different. It will be 98% water, so of course 2% is left for the sponge itself. When we squeeze the sponge, of course the weight of the sponge will not change. It's still 10 grams. And now some calculations. If 10 grams is 2%, how will we get back to the 100%? In this case up here, 10 grams were 1%. So we would have calculated 10 grams times 100, because 1% times 100 leads back to 100%. Now, in our case, 10 grams equal 2%. So we have to calculate times 50 to get from 2% back to 100. 10 grams times 50 will be 500 grams. So, obviously, if the amount of water in the weight is reduced from 99% to 98%, just 1% less, then the total weight of the wet sponge is divided by 2. 1 kilo to 500 grams. And of this 500 grams, 10 grams is the sponge, and of course then 490 grams are left for the water. I think it's really surprising if you've never seen something like this before. For another funny math problem from real life, check out this video, which talks about Homer Simpson eating pink donuts. And if you want to know more about living and working aboard of a sailboat, then check out this English vlog I made about my life. Have fun and see you soon. Bye.